Hello, welcome to C'est La Vie Tarot. Let's see what's going on with you. Let's see what's going on with love, all right? The person that's on your mind. So this is going to be a general reading, all right? And this is just going to focus on the person on your mind, the person that you're thinking about. New or old, okay? Just think about this person, all right? And let's see what we could find out. Let's see where this is going, okay? Let's see what's on their mind. But first, we're going to just get an energy of this connection. All right, if you are interested in a personal reading, all of my information is below. This is a past life connection. All right, very, very strong past life connection, amazing past life connection, which is going to bring in a lot of lessons for you, okay? It's going to bring in a lot of clarity for you in terms of where you are, where you're going, all right? Your frequency, right? So I feel like with this connection, this person that you've been thinking about connecting with, this is someone I feel like that you've had a lot of patience with, all right? Or you're going to have a lot of patience with. And I feel like it's coming from a place of, you know, I've known you before, right? We've connected a long time ago. But Spirit is asking for you to also have patience with yourself in this connection. Be kind to yourself. Be loving to yourself, okay? I do see the two of you in this energy of constantly thinking about each other, but also it's like having a relationship with your ideal self more so, okay? So there's a lot of similarities between you and this person that you're connecting with, okay? Also, be sure to hit the like button or the subscription button if you are wanting to get more of these videos, okay? Just wanted to put that out there before I connect here. There we go. I'm sorry. So someone here definitely feels as if they owe you an apology. There's some sort of hurt that was brought in at some point. We do have karmic partner here, and I feel like this person understands or feels at some point they were being very karmic, or they were vibrating in an energy where they, you know, it created some sort of resistance between you and this individual here. This person could have pulled away, or this person, you feel like they're pulling away, okay? It could have been after some sort of misunderstanding, after some sort of disagreement. But I do see someone here wanting to apologize, right? I'm wanting to come in and, you know, somewhat balance out our energy here. This person could send you a text here. I feel like for a lot of you, this person may not send a text of I'm sorry, but I feel like this person's energy is coming in from I'm sorry for not understanding myself. I'm sorry for being impatient. I'm sorry for, you know, the way that I spoke to you or the way that I came off. There's some sort of acknowledgement that's happening between you and this person. And I feel like this is something that is bringing in a lot of growth for you and this individual, honestly, because I feel like this person's also learning about themselves. And it could be you having to apologize for your tone or your energy or your ghosting-like behaviors. Okay, again, could be cross watchers as well. So take that how that resonates for you. All right, so we're going to jump in. We're going to jump in here and see what's going on with you. All right. Give me a vibe for this connection. What is the vibe for this connection, please? Tell me what's on this person's mind when they think of my viewers. What's on this person's mind? What are they thinking? This is someone here that I feel like when this person thinks of you, they try not to think of you, okay? I see this person in a place where they're trying to distract themselves at times. I feel like this person understands that when it comes to connecting with you, you require more, all right? This person thinks that you are someone, or believes that you are someone that is very serious. You're very goal-orientated. You're very focused on your goals as well. I feel like this person tends to doubt at times that they're able to give you what you deserve, or they feel like, you know, they aren't good enough is the energy I'm getting here. Okay, so this person tends to distract themselves a lot. Okay, this person tends to distract themselves with materialistic energies. This is someone here also that tends to spy a lot, watch a lot, overthink a lot, right? I feel like this person, again, if you feel like you're a bit more balanced within your, you know, your career or whatever it may be, I feel like this person is now looking at you, right? Looking at some of the things that you've possibly said to them in the past and taking those things into consideration, all right? But I do feel like this person is really curious about your energy. All right. When they think about you, they get this energy of, how can I approach this person? Or what is the best way to start some sort of new beginning with this person? But I do get this person watching you, watching your growth, watching how goal-orientated you are. So a lot of you possibly have been, again, focusing on your growth, focusing on your stability. And this person, for some reason, sees that. Okay. Or they're curious. I'm getting like, I wonder what she or he is doing. Yeah, that's the energy that I'm getting. I wonder what she or he or whoever, I wonder what they're doing, okay? I wonder what they're doing. I wonder what they're up to. I wonder what's new in their life. I wonder. There's a lot of wondering like energy, especially when it comes to your stability. It's like this person wonders what you're up to, okay? Let's see what else we have for this connection. Guide my viewers, please, for their highest good. What is the message for this? I'm also hearing this person views you as somebody that's very structured as well. There's something about the way that you go after what it is that you want that this person admires about you. Okay, you have the tower. Yeah. Let's see what's going on, guys. This person definitely did not expect to fall for you as much as they did here. We have the star energy. Someone could have like an Aquarius placement, heavy Aquarius placement, or this person could be an Aquarius here. This is someone here that still has faith, still has hope. Okay, Spirit is putting that out there. Again, I still have hope that we could work things out, that we could still come together, that we could still become one, that we could still listen to one another here. So I do see for some of you guys, there will be some sort of communication that comes in about a relationship or talks about a relationship. In the past, it looks like someone here wanted to indulge in the single life, right? They wanted to indulge in, creating some sort of boundaries at times. Although I see this person, very attracted to your energy, extremely attracted to your energy, by the way, extremely attracted to your energy and wanted to move towards you. But I feel like, there was some sort of tower moment at some point here, whether there was some sort of misunderstanding, as we saw here, or there was some sort of truth that was revealed at some point. I do see someone here also in a place of really acknowledging their emotions that they have for you, acknowledging the love that they have for you. Again, Six of Cups, a past life connection, okay? Very strong past life connection. A lot of feminine energy here. So I feel like you brought a lot of balance to this person, all right? This person feels like they're starting to understand why they met you. They're starting to understand what you mean to them, as you could see your reflection here, okay? I feel like this person's emotions are also growing for you, all right? I feel like this is something that they've already acknowledged. All right, I just want to put that out there. There's a lot of emotions here, and this person is starting to understand that. They're starting to feel that. They're starting to accept that here. And I feel like you're in a place where, you've been giving a lot of emotions and a lot of time to this person as well, although there has been some sort of, separation in the past here. Okay. I do feel like for some of you, as time went on, you started to feel like this was something that wasn't moving in your direction or going in your direction. And I do see someone here struggling with the ending of this. All right. Or what they thought. All right. So I do see someone saying, how do I move forward from this? How do I find balance again in my life here after there was some sort of ending or there was some sort of shift? I do see at some point, you were possibly communicating to this person and you expressed your emotions, you expressed your love, okay? You could have even cried or you could have, really put yourself out there and you felt like this person wasn't really understanding where you were coming from, okay? This person was still trying to learn how to communicate with you. And I do see this person coming in and wanting to bring in some sort of balance. The only issue is, I do see someone here still, trying to find a way to release their single life or trying to release a past life or trying to release some sort of burden that's been holding them back for some time. That's what I'm getting. Some of you, there may be some sort of distance currently, but I do feel like this is someone here that wants to, I see them talking to their friends about you, or you could be talking to your friends, but I do see someone here trying to gain advice or get advice about how to move on or how to move forward with you. Because at some point, I feel like someone felt like like this was completely over. This is something that wasn't going into a very balanced place. However, I do see there could be some sort of mediator or someone speaking to their counselor or their therapist or talking to, you know, someone that they trust about this connection, all right, about how they view love, about how they want to move forward with you here. Because I do see some sort of stalemate energy happening, all right? Let's get some more information here. Tell me more about this tower. Tell me about this tower. Thank you. Tell me more about this tower, please. Thank you. Okay. So I feel like in the past year, someone here felt very trapped, very stuck, very, you know, consumed with, you know, doubt. All right. This person could have been tied down or having some issues that really pulled them into a place of distracting themselves a lot. Although the chemistry and the spark and the passion was obviously still very strong, very potent. I do see this person at some point pulling back, backing up in the past year. Okay. But moving forward, I feel like you were still giving to this connection. Although this person was pulling away, you were still giving to this connection. I feel like, again, at some point you decided to detach, you decided to pull away. And I feel like that was very hard for you to do. It's extremely hard for me to detach from the person that I love, this past life connection, right? But again, I do see there is going to be some sort of communication, some sort of balance, okay? Some sort of, you know, can we talk energy that comes in for the both of you here, okay? Tell me more about how my viewers are feeling about this connection currently. How does my view, well, so there is a lot of fear, all right? For some of you, it's like, this is draining me. This could have been draining my career, draining my finances, draining my mental, draining me in a sense, right? Where it's like throwing my focus off. But again, this is more so fear, okay? Where it's like, you know, I really want to work on this connection, but it's hard. The waiting game is hard. The understanding what this person want is hard. What they're looking for is hard. So I do see someone here feeling as if like, I'm stuck to this person, but this person's not really giving me much to work with here, okay? And I feel like that may be the energy that some of you may be in, okay? And some of you may not be. This could be your person, but someone here feels very overwhelmed. Someone here is just carrying a lot of fear when it comes to the outcome of this situation or how this situation is going to pan out. Again, like I stated or I felt, there is some sort of anxiety. Okay, it's like, you know, after an argument, I start having some sort of anxiety. After the breakup, I had some sort of anxiety. After you pulled away, I started doubting this connection. Show me how this person feels about this connection. Thank you. Wow. So both of you are mirroring each other. Okay, so someone here currently is feeling like, you know, this may not work. All right. They're also starting to see the truth about this connection as well. So for a lot of you, there was some sort of, you know, abrupt, I don't want to say argument. Okay. For some of you, there was, but some sort of misunderstanding here. Okay. We didn't really understand where neither of us were coming from. Okay. So I do see you and this person in this energy of a lot of fear, a lot of blockages. I'm unsure. I'm not sure. What's next? You know, this person's also looking at this like, I don't know if we could fix this. I do see a new beginning coming in. It looks like an old way of how you two used to communicate needs to end. And for some of you, or, you know, both of you to bring in this balance into the connection, this equal give and take into the connection. I feel like that was one of the things blocking it out. Someone here could also have another relationship going on, or someone here is saying, no, I don't need to talk to anybody. So there could be that stubborn energy happening as well. But I do see someone here needing to understand how their behavior contributed to this, right? To this Ten of Wands. Because I feel like someone felt like they were overgiving. It's like this person wasn't really giving much at some point. Okay, show me more in terms of what my viewers could expect with the Star here. They're also stating that communication is something that is very important here, because they are saying that there is a lot that this person may be fearing and thinking that needs to be communicated and acknowledged. Okay, show me more, please, in terms of what my viewers could expect with the Star. Okay, what else could they expect? Thank you. Yeah. So at this time, I do see this waiting energy, okay? I feel like for a lot of you, both of you are waiting for someone to open up. Both of you are waiting for someone to say something here. It's like you say something, I say, like say something, right? I'm still waiting for you. It's at the same time, it's like both of you are waiting, but I'm also holding back because you're holding back. So we're both holding back because we're mirroring each other, okay? Show me more in terms of future. What could we expect? Wow. So I feel like there is, yeah, you there's a strong need of communication here, proper communication, all right? And I feel like that's going to allow you two to move in a more balanced direction. There's something about someone not communicating properly, okay? Give me some advice for this. Someone here is overwhelmed with the situation and they're not talking, they're not being honest with themselves, okay? It could be, someone, struggling with making a decision about ending something, or someone still in another relationship and they're not able to be honest or straightforward or open about that situation, okay? Because I do see someone here wanting to reconnect with you, but it's like it's so overwhelming for them because they're burdened with fear, they're burdened with doubt. Okay, of how things are going to work out, but at the same time, this person's still watching you. Okay, especially when you back up and pull away, this person's waiting for you here to say something to them. Give me more, please, in terms of future energy. Anything else? Advice? Thank you. Judgment. So, someone here is going to find clarity in this situation. It's like, I'm going to find a better way of not only communicating, but growing with one another. So, I do see some sort of harmonious conversation coming in, some sort of passion also, I'm feeling. All right. There's some sort of passion that may happen. Someone gets like an epiphany. Tell me more about this epiphany. Thank you. Yeah, someone's starting to realize that they're guarded. Okay, someone's starting to realize that they're guarded. Someone's going to overcome their fears and reach out with the Eight of Wands here. Okay, so I am going to reach out. I am going to open up communication. So I do see communication coming in for the two of you. I do see an offer also coming in, but this offer looks like, could we meet up? Could we talk? Could we hang out again? I know I was a bit doubtful, but I want to talk to you. Okay, and I feel like that's going to bring in some sort of balance, which actually allows both of you to move forward here. Okay, so I do see forward movement happening for you too. Closeness, more intimacy, all right, more understanding. It looks like at some point it was just like a standoff, okay? A huge standoff. Someone here is struggling with overcoming trust with someone or trust in love, okay? It's like in my past here, my past relationship didn't work and I'm struggling. Maybe I need to talk to someone. Maybe I need to, be more vulnerable. Someone here needs to put down their shield and open up, okay? But I do see this person still watching and waiting and holding back, but still watching and waiting, if that makes sense to you, okay? Give me more, please. Thank you. We have third party. There were a lot of other things that got in the way of us being together, like my pride, my doubt, and my fears. Okay. What else do we have for this connection? Thank you. We have disagreements. I wish you understood how I felt. Okay. And I feel like this is coming from a place of you two possibly having some misunderstanding, which happened, in the past here. Okay. More. Give me more, please. All right. And we have understanding. I see your side of the story. And this is what I'm seeing here with the outcome, okay? I do see someone here starting to understand where you're coming from. And this is going to come from a conversation that you two have. This is going to come from a place of opening up, right? It's like 10 of Wands popping out twice. So it seems as if communication was at a halt. It seems as if someone here was struggling because one person feels like I'm doing everything. One person feels like, hey, I don't feel like you're being honest or you're being open with me, right? So I do feel like that is going to clear up with the star being clarified by the judgment here. Okay, so I do see there is going to be some sort of equal grounds where we could get back and we could open up this in intimacy here and reignite the spiritual connection that you two have, because there is a very strong connection happening within this love story here. I'll talk to you soon. Okay, have a beautiful one. Again, if you are interested in a personal reading, all of my info is below. Have a great one and stay beautiful.